So our next speaker is virtual. Sorry, we're going to have our international contingent with the next two speakers. So to preserve that carbon footprint, they are virtual. So the first one is Dr. Gennaro D'Amato, who is professor of respiratory medicine at the University of Naples. He is the chairman of the committee of the World Allergy Organization on Aerobiology, Biodiversity, and Allergy, and was a member of the G7 International Committee on Climate Change and Health. And he'll be talking about climate change, extreme atmospheric events, and trigger factors of severe asthma.
Adesso credo. Thanks for the invitation to speak on climate change, extreme atmospheric events, and the trigger factors of severe asthma. I haven't conflicts of interest. The climate change is global, affecting everyone. Rising temperatures, warming oceans, rising sea levels, and accelerated melting of glaciers are some of the measurable effects of climate change, along with the intense droughts, increased air pollution, water scarcity or flooding, earlier and more intense pollen seasons, severe fires, catastrophic storms, and declining biodiversity. There are several aspects connected with the climate change, as you can see here. We need to consider floods, storms, but also the trigger factors of respiratory allergies, such as pollens, molds, and so on. The effect of climate change is also terrible with several flooding, such as this recent flooding happened in Italy. There is an interaction between components of air pollution and aeroallergens, as you can see here, and there is an increase of the effects of air pollution and also of aeroallergens in sensitized subjects. As you can see here, there is an interaction between components of air pollution, such as pollen grains and components of air pollution. We need to consider the genetic background of sensitized subjects and the trigger factors of respiratory effects. We need to consider that prevalently the carbon dioxide able to induce climate change, inducing increasing in temperature and humidity, changes in the amount, distribution, and intensity of precipitation event, increase in the intensity and the frequency of a certain extreme weather events such as thunderstorms, floods, and hurricanes. However, anthropogenic activity play a key role in the climate change. And considering the increase of carbon dioxide in atmosphere, it is important to reduce this increase, because also when we are able to reduce the carbon dioxide, the presence in atmosphere of this gaseous component is for a century or more, and we need to be active as soon as possible. Pollution is able to act on allergens, and as a consequence of air pollution, we have more allergens, higher allergenicity, higher airway responsiveness. And the climate change is able to induce the effects by direct way, acting on temperature, humidity, rainfall, barometric pressure, extreme weather events, inducing respiratory allergy and asthma with these direct effects, but also by indirect way on temperature, humidity, rainfall, barometric pressure, and wind. In response to climate change, plants can move to where the climate is suitable, adapt to the new climate, become extinct. We have studied with other colleagues in the world the effect of carbon dioxide and the climate change on plants, on allergenic plants. And we have observed that the plants flower earlier in urban areas than in the corresponding rural areas, with the earlier pollination of about 2-4 days. There is an observation very interesting of Wayne and co-workers that a doubling of the atmospheric carbon dioxide concentration is able to stimulate ragweed pollen production by 61%. In a recent manuscript, we have focalized the problem of the increase of allergenic activity of allergenic plants induced by carbon dioxide. However, higher levels of carbon dioxide can lead to enhanced photosynthesis and a higher pollen production in allergenic plants. We need to consider that in the last 50 years, 50% of pluvial forests of our planet have been destroyed. And this is an important topic, considering the importance to have the forests for the reduction of climate change of our planet. And in response to the increase in atmospheric carbon dioxide concentration, tropical forests act as a global carbon sink. And we need to consider the importance of forests. And we are informed about the reduction of forests in Amazonia, and also of several abatement of trees. In this topic, we have produced several publications with our group on these topics: projections of the effects of climate change on allergic asthma, the contribution of aerobiology, and in particular a paper on meteorological conditions, climate change, new emerging factors, and asthma, and the related allergic disorders, a statement of the World Allergy Organization. And this is the paper published some years ago, and with the focalization, with the contribute of several authors, and with the focalization in several sub-chapters, such as sandstorms, climate change on respiratory allergy, pollen allergy and the meteorological factors, molds, rain, humidity, dampness, migration and urbanization, cold weather, wildfires and asthma, and so on. However, observational evidence indicates that recent regional changes in climate, particularly temperature increases, have already affected a diverse set of physical and biological systems in many parts of the world. And other papers are this one, with this is an editorial on allergy with Professor Kazmiakdis, on global warming, climate change, air pollution, and allergies. And another recent editorial is on the storms and asthma, and also in about the meteorological phenomena and the particles deriving from the Saudi Arabian Peninsula in Mediterranean area, and such as dust storms, events associated with the upper and the lower respiratory symptoms,
and an increase of respiratory admissions to hospitals. Here there are other publications recent over the last 3 months on the effect of climate change on respiratory allergy, in particular pediatric allergy and immunology, impress on environmental influences on childhood asthma induced by climate change, and the recent publication on current opinion in pediatrics on climate change, air pollution, pollen allergy, and the extreme atmospheric events. And here there are other publications with focalization that the pollen aeroallergens and allergenicity are influenced by climate, humidity, temperature, and air pollution. Another problem very important in our opinion is the study of allergen carrying microparticles in atmosphere. We have studied the pollen fragments, starch granules, and other cytoplasmic granules, non-pollen plant parts, non-plant particulate matter. In particular, we have observed that subjects, also children affected by pollen allergy, should be alert to danger of being outdoors during a thunderstorm in the pollen season. And here, a picture of an event in Naples with the pollens of parietaria ruptured during a thunderstorm in a pollen season. This is a picture of our paper on Journal of Allergy and Clinical Immunology, and with focalization of intact pollen of activated and high allergen increasing pollen and of ruptured pollens. During a thunderstorm, in some occasions, it is possible to have the rupture of pollens with the release of cytoplasmic components in the atmosphere. However, also thunderstorm-associated asthma outbreaks are not frequent. It is possible to observe in clinical practice during a thunderstorm in the pollen season with a decrease of temperature, single cases of patients with the increase of allergic respiratory symptoms, not only nasal, such as rhinorrhea and sneezing, but also bronchial, such as cough and asthma, and sometimes also very severe asthma. And we have collaborated with the Victorian state government of Australia about the events, very terrible, happened in Australia with some deaths and other asthma crisis during the thunderstorm. And we received the final report on literature review and the implication for public health advice from the Ministry of Victoria in Australia. However, in conclusion, what can we do to reduce the effects of climate change? It is important to decrease use of fossil fuels and controlling vehicle emissions, to reduce the private traffic in towns, to increase use of public transport, as cycling and walking. It is important to plant in cities non-allergenic trees, for example, no betulae, no betulaceae, no cupressaceae, but other non-allergenic trees. It is important to minimize outdoor activity on days with high pollution, to suggest patients live in remote areas from heavy traffic, if possible, of course, to reduce the meat consumption. However, climate change mitigation measures also are able to reduce air pollution. Thank you very much for your attention.